This is getting started with 16-bit Intel assembly with DOSBox-X and Turbo Assembler. Prerequisites, you must have DOSBox-X installed. It can be installed on Windows, macOS, or even GNU Linux operating systems. And you must have the Turbo Assembler binaries. First, you must decide where you want to put your files and also your binaries. I have decided to work in the home Yinli TP folder, and my code will be in the directory lab, and my binaries will be in DOS. If you're on Windows, you might have your working directory like this, your code like directory like this, and also your binaries directory like this. Take note of the slash. If you are on Windows, your slash would be in the opposite direction. Right, so let's start your DOSBox-X, and you need to first mount your file. So we will mount it to drive C. So my working directory, like I said before, is home yinli tp, and we will mount that. Now, we will change your drive. To do that, we just type in the name of the drive and also a colon. See, you have changed to the C drive. Now, we need to set a path. So the path is where DOS will look for your binary. So it is crazy to put your Turbo Assembler binary in every code directory that you use. So what we'll do is we will put the binaries, the executables, your Turbo Assembler, your Turbo Linker in one directory and tell DOS to find those executables in that directory. So what we'll do is we'll set path. Make sure that you do not type in a space, percent path percent semicolon. We are in C. And my binaries are located in DOS TASM binary. Do take note that DOS does not differentiate between uppercase and lowercase letters. So C DOS TASM bin and C DOS TASM bin is the same to DOS. So we will just add the path now. Now we will test that out. So I do have some code in here. So we'll change directory into lab. Let's take a look. I'll go into number 2. All right, and I will list it out again. I will now try to do TASM at 2.asm. Right, that means, as you can see here, I do not have a TASM.exe file in this directory, but it is finding the Turbo Assembler, which means this is working. All right, so what we'll do now is we'll automate this. We do not want to type this every time we go into DOSBox-X. So we will automate this. We go to main, we go to configuration tool, we go to autoexec.bat. And what we'll do is we will just type in what we typed in just now to mount your working directory and also your setting the path. So what we'll do is we will mount C and then we'll change the directory and we'll also set the path. Take note that when you are in DOS, if you're a Linux user, you have to change the direction of your slash. All right, that should do. If you do want to have it set to your code directory, you can also add that in here as well, but I will not do that. So what we'll do now is, okay, save it. Use that one, save it, close. All right, now we exit DOSBox and we'll try starting DOSBox again. You would not see this, don't worry about it. As you can see here, DOSBox has now automatically mounted C, changed the drive to C, and also set our path for us. So we don't have to do this every time we do. We go into DOSBox. Now, so to move around in DOSBox, there are a few commands. You may not be familiar with this text interface, but you'll get used to it in a while. So we have cd for change directory. We have cd dot dot. All right, then you have copy source destination. So I will demonstrate that now. So we'll go into lab and we'll go into number two. Let's take a look at what we have here. So for example, I want to copy let's say add to dot asm and copy it to add 21.asm. Right, so we have see that one file is copied. Let's take a look. Add to dot asm and we have now add 21.asm. Right, and then let's say we want to move it. So we use the move command. The move command can also be used to rename. So I'll try to rename the add21.asm file into add22.asm file. Right, now we'll list this again. We'll see that add21.asm has now been renamed to add22.asm. Right, we can also make a directory. So let's make a directory called test, right? See, we have now a directory named test. We can go into that directory. It's empty. And then we can also get out of that directory. Delete can be used to delete a file. If you want to delete a directory, it's called delete tree. So we'll first delete the test directory. Yes, do that. And then later we'll also want to delete what we have added, which is add22.asm. Right. So now my directory is clean again. Right, so the basics for using, for writing assembly code, I guess, would be write the code, and then you type TASM. I'll use an example here, add2.asm. You can have a name for your OBJ file later, but if you don't type anything, so I can say, for example, I want to name this add2034.obj. This will give me a add2034.obj file after this. But if I don't write anything, it will just give me a add2.obj file automatically. And then what we'll do is we'll link the file. Add2.obj. And then it's fine. There's no stack in this code. And then we can run the exe file. Right? It doesn't matter that it doesn't print anything to standard out. Alright, so a few tips. Keep your names under 8 characters. If you have names longer than 8 characters, DOS would append a 1 to it. Let's see if I can find an example. All right, here. This is my working directory. This is called applications, but it has been appended to applic1. So this is a warning for you all. Just keep your names under 8 characters. You can use the tab key on your keyboard to autocomplete. So if you can see just now what I did, let's go into the code directory again. let's go into 3 now. So, my bad. So let's say I'll take the hello.asm. So what we can do is I'll just type hel tab. You give me the exe file, which I don't want. I can change that to the asm file and press tab again. So this is autocomplete. So best of luck.